can't be sleeping, keep on waking without the woman next to me. Guilt is burning, inside I'm hurting. This ain't a feeling I can keep. So blame it on the night. Don't blame it on me. Don't blame it on me. Blame it on the night. Don't blame it on me. Don't blame it on me. Blame it on the night. Don't blame it on.
Hi guys, so this video is gonna be about Hong Kong. Let's start with the good things about Hong Kong. It's just my opinion, so they don't take it that seriously. Okay, the first thing is that you have this perfect octopus card here. So you put the money inside and you take it everywhere you want. You pay almost everywhere with this card, and instead of cash with you, you have this card inside, the money here. So it's perfectly nice and useful. The people here are very helpful, but you have to be really careful who you're gonna ask, because the old generation, they don't know English, so they're gonna answer you in Chinese. So you have to be really careful. If you need help or something, of course they're gonna be really helpful and they want to help you, but sometimes they not even know, but they're gonna answer you and they will tell you something really different. So if you wanna really help or ask something, just somebody who knows English, and they look like 100% that they know about it. Hear about the traffic and all the stuff, it's pretty good. You have the metro, you have trams, you have buses, you have even boats. So you can go from one side to other side, because Hong Kong is an island. So this is like perfect. The shops here, some of them, like the most important, like 7-Eleven or Circle K, in which you can find anything like from food, pharmacy, are open 24 hours, so you just go down, grab something and you're done. Of course, here are amazing places to go and see. Anything. You spend your time here, like you can do anything every day super fast, because this city, it's like you wake up and you have to do something. Like you really wanna walk, you really want to see everything, so spending time in Hong Kong just flies, and it's pretty amazing even if you walk. For somebody who is really like doing sports, there are free playgrounds here. You don't even need to go to the gym. So it's pretty good. I forgot to say about the hiking, that you can also hike here. Amazing place to go to hike, like Lion Rock or Victoria Peak. Of course, these two are the most like famous here, and you will have amazing view and also taking pictures and everything. It's pretty good. You can find some different ones also. Every Wednesday the museums are free, so for somebody who likes history and all the stuff, you can go on Wednesday and just be there free. So that's pretty good. You can also go to some buildings and have really good view.
I see the moon, oh, when you're looking at the sun. Not a fool, no, you're not fooling anyone.
In some of them you need to bring your ID, some of them they are free, so you just take the elevator and take pictures. Yeah, and 99% of the people are talking English, so everybody knows English here, which is amazing, so you will not get lost for sure. Let's say the bad things. The city here is noisy, it's crowded and loud. And that's about the people, like when you want to go outside, you will not find any day without people. And so small, so you have to really be patient and keep calm when you go somewhere, because even in a tram, in metro, everywhere you want to walk, you will be just so stressed out. So you just take it easy, take your time. People walk slow, they just change their mind, they just stop, they turn, they just walk like ants, they don't have the one way. Sometimes some of the Chinese reaction are really weird, so you don't have to take it personally. For example, like when you want to walk inside the elevator and you want to let somebody inside, like you're doing the good thing, they will not even appreciate, they will not even say thank you or something, because for them it doesn't exist, because there are so many people and they want to be first. So if they're gonna like punch you like or push you, just don't take it personally or seriously, because that's the way how they grown up. If you are not the first, you will not get the position. Or for example, in the supermarket, if you have any sale or something and you want to buy the stuff, you have to be one of the first, unless you will not buy it in 1 hour, everything it will be done. So it's hard, but just ignore it, just let it be and enjoy the time. Yeah, for the Hong Kong is an expensive country, so you really need to save money if you want to like really enjoy it here. The food is expensive, like to live here is expensive, so just spend your money as you want, but you have to be prepared that it's gonna fly. If some of the people, they're gonna like take picture of you, just staring of you, just talking about you in front of you, so just don't care, you know. So, where to go and what to see? Of course, Van Chai is in the middle of Hong Kong, and there are so many things here, restaurants everywhere, anything you want. You should for sure try the local food, but you have to be careful where to go and what to try. In a good restaurant, don't just go there because you think that it's expensive and good. You never know what they put in your food. And always ask for, in English, like the food, what they're gonna bring you, like what is inside. So good bars and parties here, so for young people and even for somebody who really like that, there is like it's perfect here. It's perfect to go in a central and just have some drinks and really good fun. Yeah, you have to be careful a little bit. You can try the street food, like they're just making the food like in front of you and everything, but you have to be really careful like what you're gonna choose. And a colon side, it's on the other side of the island because Hong Kong is an island, so there are more shops. It's so different, like on the, this side which I am, like it's Van Chai or Central and also Castle Bay. Kowloon side is like a little bit more opened. You have the Temple Street there, the Ladies Market. You can shop anything you want and for really good money, and you always like try for a better price, so it's really fun. You have the fish market there. Central, you have a small lunar park. If you want to go there, nothing special. Well, sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water and I think of all the things, what you're doing, and in my head I paint a picture. Cause since I come home, well, my body. We went there because it was just idea at that time to went there. In a common side we have also like the, I think the party street is there, I'm not sure. Of course you should go to Disneyland. You have the zoo, just in the middle of the city you have a zoo. Nothing big, but just something at least. You can just walk there, take some nice pictures. you should go to Buddha, to Big Buddha, which is on the other side. Also, there is a ferry, which you take the boat and you can go to Macau. It's really near island here. You can visit it. It was a Brazilian colony or Portuguese, I think, before. And it's really good mixed again with Chinese and Portuguese, Brazilian food, you can find there anything. So it's a really nice place to go and see if you have the opportunity to go.
Red food, Mr. Worldwide, Vane, Rush.
You took my love, I thought I was the only one. You took my love, it feels like you did it for fun. You took my love, but my heart keeps telling me you're the one. You took my love, la da 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 dee.
From or where you been at, I'm letting you know what's up. And if you don't, I'll play by the rules, huh, baby, you get cut. I talk so much, you took my love, fuck.
You took my love, I thought I was the only one. You took my love, it feels like you did it for fun. You took my love, but my heart keeps telling me you're the one. You took my love, la da 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 dee.
The weather now, it's like not exactly cold, but it's cold for somebody who is living here. It's like 17 degrees now and it's March, beginning of March, and even all the Christmas time we spent here, it's not exactly too much cold, but the best time for traveling, I think, as I said before, it's spring and autumn. In general, I want to say like Hong Kong is an amazing place to visit, to see the experiences, the people and everything, the culture will give you something really to your life, like not only to learn about myself, about yourself, but to improve as a human of this earth.
Thank you. Oh!